Estimaker Electronics introduces its totem pole solution based on SiC technology and SCR thyristors. We will see first the advantages of the bridgeless totem pole architecture and of the usage of SCR as a rush current limiter. Then we will show you the performances of our 3.6 kW PFC board, having a look also to the key ST product families present in the board. The higher efficiency in the totem pole boost helps to increase the power density. Using SCRs instead of relay to limit the inrush current increases the reliability and is particularly suitable in automotive applications, where it is recommended to avoid moving parts. A standard boost has the disadvantage that two diodes of the rectifier bridge are always in series, and this has an impact on the efficiency. The totem pole architecture gives instead better efficiency, but has a more complex input voltage sensing and requires MOSFETs with almost no reverse recovery charge of the body diode, so SiC MOSFETs. In a simple boost, you have three junctions in series, two bridge diodes and one other element, either the MOSFET or the boost diode. While in the totem pole, you have only two junctions, one diode and one MOSFET. During the positive half wave of the mains voltage, the current flows always through SCR2, which behaves like a diode, and the choke charging is controlled by MOSFET S1. When it is on, the current in the inductor increases, while when it is off, the current can flow through the recovery diode of MOSFET S2. During off time, S2 can be switched on to reduce the voltage drop. During the negative half wave of the mains voltage, the behavior is the same, but current flows through the opposite elements. Using SCRs as a rush current limiter in totem pole PFC brings several advantages, like a smooth, progressive, but fast power up, robustness to surge, and no EMI noise. When a rush current limitation is realized by a relay, standard diodes are used as a returning current path, and the current at startup is limited by a resistor in series, which is short-circuited by the relay after a given time. While in a solution with SCRs, at startup the SCRs are enabled just during proper pulses, thus allowing a slow charge of the output capacitor. This can be done just by a microcontroller. The solution with relay is simple but has several disadvantages, like audible noise, problems related to the aging of the metal contact, slower charging time. It is also not usable in systems with vibrations, like in automotive applications. SCRs have instead no electromechanical bouncing, and the procedure allows also a faster charging time. In the example shown here, we have 120 milliseconds in case of a rush current done through SCRs versus 400 milliseconds in case of relay. Although in general SCRs have higher voltage drop than standard diodes, this difference is negligible at high currents. We can see in the example here that the difference is minimal, just 20 millivolt, at the nominal current of this application, 16 ampere, and in worst case of 150 degrees. Therefore, the usage of SCRs in such high power applications does not impact significantly on the efficiency. ST Microelectronics 3.6 kW totem pole PFC achieves very high efficiency, extremely low THD, and digital tuning of peak inrush current. Made to work with both US and European input voltage range, this board provides a 400 volt output, working with a maximum input current of 6 ampere RMS. It achieves a peak efficiency of 97.7% with a THD of 4.7%. It has been tested up to 45 degrees and is compliant to the main standards. The main semiconductor products inside are two 650 SiC MOSFETs, two isolated drivers, two 1200 V SCRs, an STM32 microcontroller, and the Viper 26 for the auxiliary power supply. At startup, the SCR gate signals enable the SCRs just during some pulses, in order to limit the AC inrush current. The algorithm sweeps the triggering angle backward from 180 degrees to 0 degrees. SiC MOSFETs operate in safe synchronous conduction mode. As it can be seen from the oscilloscope waveform capture, after MOSFET S1 is turned off, there is a dead time of 200 nanoseconds before MOSFET S2 is turned on. Efficiency is very high at all loading conditions, higher than 95% already at 500 watts, that is 15% of the maximum load. THD is below 10% starting from 25% of the maximum load. The microcontroller implements digitally the load feedforward, which improves the load regulation and the load transient response. The picture shows the recovery of the output voltage after 0 to 100% and 100% to 0 load steps. The board is equipped with an overtemperature protection mounted on the heatsink. The pictures show the temperature reached by the SiC MOSFETs and the SCRs at maximum load when the fan is on. 83 degrees for the SiC MOSFETs and 71 degrees for the SCRs, in both cases well below the maximum junction temperature of the components. ST SiC MOSFETs can work up to 200 degrees. And STSCRs up to 150 degrees, ensuring high reliability and the possibility to reduce the heatsink. STSCR thyristor portfolio include a wide range of products to work from low to very high power, to handle high temperature applications and with high performance characteristics. ST1200V thyristors are born to work in harsh industrial applications, like motor drives, UPS, charging stations, renewable, and also in automotive applications. There is indeed a good number of products with automotive grade qualification. There are several package options available, like D2PAC, TO220, TO247, TO247 with long leads, top 3 insulated, and new ASPAC Smith. ST second generation 650V SiC MOSFETs are widely used in all kinds of power conversion and in motor drives. They are available in two sizes, with RDS(on) of 0.55 ohm or 20 milliohm, in several packages and in industrial and automotive grade. ST isolated gate drivers are available in single channel and in dual channel versions. Both parts are 1700V rated and have 4A SiC and source current capability. There are two options of STGAP2S, the single channel gate driver. One with separated outputs to turn on and off the external MOSFET, and one with Miller clamp to avoid induced turn-on. Thanks for listening to this presentation with Estimetro Electronics.